Good morning, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here amongst all of you. I will be talking more from a practitioner's view. So you can expect more examples. You can expect something more on ground reality is what we are facing. And I want to keep it very simple so that we all understand it and we go back with at least two, three themes from the today's session. And rather than making banking is anyway a very complex entity, our endeavor at Fino is to make it as simple as possible, and that's what we are trying to also come out through this presentation. So we talk about Bharat, unlike India, because we feel the need for phygital or the need for real banking is in Bharat rather than India. India is overbanked. All of us have multiple accounts. If we have a show of hands, all of you may have 4 to 5 accounts. Maybe 2 or 3 of them would be active. The moment you go outside the metros, you will see a lot of people have only maybe half account, one account. When I say half account, it's like a family account. So husband, wife having one joint account as such. So the real need for Bharat, the real need for banking is actually in Bharat. And that's what we are trying to cover ourselves. And we feel phygital is the way if you want to actually make banking possible in Bharat rather than India. India is, as I said, overbanked. So what? This is not working. Maybe we'll have to connect it. Okay. But this is okay. This. So can you? This is okay. Little complicated, but we'll get around this. Sometime in 2013, Mark Anderson, one of the leaders in venture capitalists in US, actually said the retail guys are going to be out of business. The e-commerce will become the place where everyone buys. So that was his prediction in way back 6 years back. And when we look at 2019, we don't see anything of that happening. In fact, if you see, a lot of people who are into digital business is actually getting into physical ecosystem now. You see some of those companies like Paperfry, Lenskart, today I read about First Cry. A lot of them already have a good digital presence, but they feel for them to grow the business, they need to have a equally good physical presence. So that comes to a question that when we see such things happening in the e-commerce space, why we don't see that in happening in the bank? And it also comes to the fact that when we look at our social beings or people who are there, they need both human touch as well as they need a social being. So that is where the connection has to be with the consumer. And when we say consumer, we also say that consumer is the king. And when we say consumer is the king, we also look at what is the real need of the consumer. The real need of the consumer is actually, and that's what the survey also said, that about physical and digital presence. 79% of the people in the consumer space said they are more loyal to brands that have great online as well as offline presence. 66% of the consumers said that we lose trust in the brand where the physical presence does not match the digital presence. So some of the companies who have been very successful in digital but have not been very successful in physical has been because they have not been able to present a unique experience in both the ecosystems. So that is where we need to learn from some of these companies when we come to banking, that how can we make it really possible. How is it really relevant for the banks? My own learning in the past so many years has been that banking has always been in terms of the new things or the innovation which is happening is more happening in the FMCG, the consumer durables, the consumer space. While bankers have always been taking a very, I would not say laid back approach, but still I would say an approach in which they have been more because of the money, the financial needs of the customers which are involved, they have been more slow in taking or adopting technology to some extent. But that thing is now changing. We are seeing in the last few years, a lot of new technology innovation has started to happen. But how is it all relevant for the banks as such? When we look at some of the data which is there, we see India becoming the fifth largest economy in the world. Soon we'll take over UK. Our per capita GDP, and that's a very, very important number, has actually grown from $1,400 to more than $2,000 in the last 6 years. So if I look at the data in 2013, we were at $1,450 per capita. That has grown to more than $2,000 per capita, which means that there is roughly a growth of about 40%. And that growth is not only coming from the urban India, that growth is also coming from the rural India, the Bharats of the world. And plus, India economy is going to grow. So just imagine that the economy is going to double itself in the next 5 years. The per capita income, which is crossing 2,000, might cross 3,000 in the next couple of years. That means that there's a lot of opportunities. There are a lot of businesses which can be done. But what, where is the consumer really spending that money, the income which is getting generated? Where is the spending actually happening? Will become the third largest consumer market in the world. Indian consumer spending is expected to grow to $6 trillion by 2030 from the current value of about $1.5 trillion. That means 4 times growth will happen in the next 10 years. And the maximum part of that $6 trillion, which is roughly $2 trillion, will actually happen in the affordable mid-price segments. That means a lot of growth will actually happen not above the middle part of the pyramid, but just around the middle part and the lower middle of the pyramid. So that is a big opportunity for all bankers sitting here, for all the technology companies who have come to exhibit their products, that when they look at products, when they look at technology, when they look at any solution, they should keep in mind that the growth in India is going to double in the next 5 years. The consumer spend is going to grow 4 times in the next 10 years. And maximum spend is going to come in the middle segment of the middle of the pyramid. So your solution has to be based on technologies which can actually go and deliver such kind of products in rural India or for the middle segment. So developing high-end products is a good thing, but developing from a business point of view products which can actually be sold in Bharat, which can be implemented in Bharat, is something which we need to work upon, because Indian market is going to grow, and as well as the fact that it's going to grow at the middle of the pyramid rather than at the top only. What we are also seeing is kind of a tsunami, I would say, a lot of this credit actually goes to Jio. The data usage actually has created a lot of opportunities for a lot of companies, a lot of banks. What we hear today, what Eric and Mr. Hoda were speaking about, comes from the fact that a lot of data is now being available in our hands. We are seeing 300 million smartphones there. And on an average, I remember a few years back when we used to use our mobile phones for data, we used to go to in a hotel, and I share this very frequently in office also. The first thing when we used to check into a hotel, we used to ask for his Wi-Fi password. What is your Wi-Fi password? Because we wanted to always be a guest in the hotel, and I had a free internet there. I think those days have passed, and thanks to the boom which has happened in the telecom industry in the last couple of years, we see that data has become as a very easy commodity, I would say. From a usage of roughly about 100 MBs, now we have crossed maybe 5 to 10 GBs. So 5 to 10 GB is an average consumption of data. 230 million daily average users of WhatsApp is there. So that is where the boom is happening. That is where data is getting used, which means that there's a lot of opportunities for all of us in the data space. But does it really mean that that is the only space which is available? Does it mean that India has become a completely data or a complete digital company? I've heard speakers before me who have also said the same thing, that we need both the ecosystems. While India has been a 90% cash market, we are seeing, along with that, we are seeing that Google Pay, which launched its services, has seen 8x growth in the last one year. We are seeing UPI, which launched about 1.5-2 years back, about to touch $1 trillion of transactions. So we are seeing explosion happening everywhere in the country. The reason for explosion is the fact that people are moving from high value transactions to small value transactions to micro transactions. When we used to transact, or when you used to go to an ATM to withdraw cash, you would probably withdraw 10,000, 15,000 rupees, but now you withdraw in thousands, 2,000, 5,000. Because the transaction values are now started to come down. People are no longer scared, thanks to the ecosystem of our country. People are no longer scared that they have to keep cash in their pockets always. They know that wherever they can, they will be able to find maybe a point where they can withdraw some money in smaller denominations, or they would probably go and do digital transactions. So that is where the explosion is happening, both on the cash side as well as on the digital side. So what does it mean? I think it means that there is a lot of opportunities for banks. 250 million households will come out of poverty by 2030. We expect the rural growth to continue to grow faster than the urban growth. Rural is touching nearly 10% growth vis-a-vis about 8.5% for urban. we say the 80% of the incremental spends by 2030 is going to come from the middle income consumers. So that gives the opportunity which is there for all of us. However, what we also see that the main challenge is reach. How do you make banking possible to everybody? How do you actually make it accessible? So what is the right approach? Is it ATM the right approach, or a digital reach the right approach, or maybe the answer lies somewhere in middle? But the question is, how do we do a deep dive into the Bharat and where the opportunity is even more? We see in the last few years, 80% of the people already have bank accounts, 190 million. When we started Fino 12 years back, the number used to be very different. We used to talk about 600 million people not having bank account, thanks to all the schemes of the government, especially the Jandan scheme. We see 80% of the people having bank accounts. We see 190 million people only left out of unbanked population as such. 50% of the accounts are still inactive. That shows that while we have been able to solve the problem of accounts, but we have not been able to solve the problem of accessibility. But we also see that in the last few years, the tapering of accounts and the deposits have started to happen. So what is the real reason? Is this lack of physical infrastructure the real culprit? What else could be the reason? We also see that in the last few years, the beefing up of the physical infrastructure has not happened. If you see the last graphs, 2013, we see a peak, and then in the last 3-4 years, we are seeing that there is a drop in the number of branches. We are also seeing that there is a drop in ATM. Now, with the ATM cost going up, we also expect that number of ATMs will actually come down. Is digital going to be the solution, or is physical not the way to go forward? Digital has its own challenges. Challenges could be around digital literacy, could be around financial literacy. So how can we really solve the problem? And these customers are unique. People who are earning 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 4 lakh or rupees have basically three big problems, which we call CSR. CSR in our corporate jargons means corporate social responsibilities. But in Fino, we call it convenience, simplicity and respect. So I think these are the three big problems of the common people in the country, that they don't get convenient solutions, they want very simple solutions, and they want respect from their bankers. I think these three things, if we are able to address for this customer segment, we can solve a lot of problems and address this big opportunity which is there. So what we feel at Fino is Phygital is the answer, combining the merits of both the physical as well as the digital ecosystem. The physical and the digital ecosystem in our parlance will work by way of acquisition. You have an acquisitions engine, which could be a physical, could be your kiosk, could be doorstep banking, could be merchants, could be branches. Then the digital journey starts for the consumer. From the physical chain, you do a digital assist. So digital assist is before we actually move to digital self-service. So digital assist means that a person actually helps the customer download the app, makes him convenient to use the app. The app has to be very simple. And then the customer actually goes and does self-service. And we have seen this happening in our own ecosystem. And this physical system can work along with merchants, can work with banking outlets, can also do a lot of doorstep banking, can also help in mobile banking. We can talk about the bank and the bank approach, which is like a partnership approach, which actually can be possible. This slide shows how physical and the digital ecosystem actually works in Fino. We have our own network, we have a partnership which is there. There are banking outlets, there are a lot of merchants, there are a lot of people who walk into the branch and then they move actually into a self-service model. We also work with a lot of banks on the partnerships, could be BC partnerships, could be payment partnerships, could be API banking. Eric just spoke about API banking. At Fino, what we endeavor is the fact that we need to have, if we want to become a national player, and the payment banks are supposed to be a national players, and the advantage of a payments bank is the distribution reach, which is so very critical for the success of the bank, is that we need to be present everywhere in the country. We can't just pick a geography and say, oh, I will be in one state. We have to be there everywhere in the country, which means that I have to be there across all the people in the country. So our endeavor is to be with every 5,000 people, there has to be a Fino point which is there. Right now, we have 75,000 own Fino points, which means that we are 15,000 people, we have a point. Our endeavor is to reach to 5,000 people. We have a lot of API partnerships where we have more than 125,000 points, which are indirectly part of the Fino ecosystem. So roughly 200,000 eco points are there. We also have a big ecosystem on digital in Fino. We have the mobile app, we have FastTag, we have UPI, we have net banking. We are seeing a lot of push. In fact, we are seeing that people who have physical model went to a digital assist are now moving to a digital self-service. We are seeing their balances, their activity level far higher. As such, the proof of the pudding is in actually eating, and in terms of what we see is that the phygital approach in Fino has actually helped us grow 5 times in the last 1.5 years. When Fino started its bank, we used to do 50 crores of transactions per day. Now we have reached a level of 250 crores per day. Our endeavor is to reach 500 crores by next year. So this approach has actually helped us in growing, in addressing the big opportunity, the big market which is there. These are some of the stories of our customers. This guy in Ara, Bihar, talks about samosi ki dukaan aur aankhon mein restaurant ka khwab. How can it be really be made possible? Is made possible that you give him banking as per his convenience, which is simple, and give him respect. Everybody wants respect. And that is something which we as bankers miss many times. Some other stories which are also there, this guy in Ajay in Noida talks about the fact that he wants to get married. But he wants to get married only if he has a saving of 1 lakh of rupees. So how does it talk about saving? Yesterday I read a report in Economic Times which said that our savings to GDP ratio has fallen down from 33% to 30%. That means there's a drop of 10% in the savings in the last 4-5 years. So that's a big drop. So that means that a lot of people are actually not coming ahead and saving their money in the banks. And financial inclusion is all about saving, and Fino is all about hardworking Indian. And that is from me, and hopefully post the session we'll have some time to interact and I can share some more thoughts. But thank you all to be first of all to be here, to hear to me, and to hear to me patiently, and all the best for the event. Thank you.